So here's how I started to think about it. So let's say, how can we represent the idea that we have an uncertain ending? Well, one way would be if we had some kind of generic probability distribution over the number of rounds that the game's going to be played. But this seemed like the simplest idea that I could think of. So here we have our two criminals, and what they're going to do is they're going to play a round of Prisoner's Dilemma, but at the end of that round, they're going to flip a coin, and with probability 1 minus gamma, that will be the last round, it's all over. But with probability gamma, they're actually going to play again. And they do this after each round, and so each round is basically statistically independent of the other rounds.
I see.
So the setup here is with probability gamma, the game continues. Now, notice that I chose gamma here. This was it's representing a probability here, but in the past, we've used this to represent a discount factor.
Mm-hmm.
But that actually is the same thing, right? In the normal discounting, we say that the value that you get one step from now is discounted downward by gamma, and that's exactly what you'd take if you worked out the expected value of a game where you continue making steps with probability gamma, and with probability 1 minus gamma, it ends and you get 0 from then until the rest of time. So every round here could be your last, or not, right? It could be that you actually get to continue playing. Does that make some sense?
That makes perfect sense.
Awesome. All right. So this is exactly that kind of situation where, well, here, let me ask you a question. What's the expected number of rounds of this game?
Well, I'll bet it's finite if gamma is less than 1.
Yes, I even wrote that down.
Yeah, I'm smart. Or at least I can read.
Sure, but specifically, we can actually write it as a function of gamma.
Let's see. If gamma were something like 99%, then I would expect it to be about 100, right?
Yeah, I think that's right.
Yeah.
So is that your answer? My function of gamma is, if gamma is 0.99, the answer is 100.
Yeah, something like that.
It's not a total function, but it's a function.
Well, it's a sample. I mean, you do machine learning. Why don't you tell me what the function would be given that sample?
Well, we can make it a quiz, or I could just tell you.
Why don't you just tell me?
All right. So 1 over 1 minus gamma is the answer. It works for your example.
Mm-hmm.
1 minus 0.99 is 1/100th, and we're talking 1 over that, so that you get 100. And yeah, we could go through the argument as to why that's what it is, but this 1 over 1 minus gamma is what shows up all the time. If gamma is 0, then we're talking about 1 over 1. The game lasts 1 round. That's exactly what we'd expect.
Mm-hmm.
As gamma gets closer and closer to 1, this quantity is getting closer and closer to infinity.
Right.
So, in fact, if you know, it becomes unbounded as gamma hits 1. So, so this is the expected number of rounds. And so that means, so as you said, if gamma is 0.99, it's 100 rounds. And we already reasoned that at 100 rounds, the whole thing falls apart.
Right. Huh. And I noticed the 1 over 1 minus gamma, of course, is just like the way we did discount factors when we started doing MDPs in the first place.
Exactly. Yeah, that kind of links them together.
That's actually kind of neat.